Home to nearly a fifth of the global population, India is a demographic powerhouse whose high rate of economic growth is tipped to make it the world's largest economy by 2050. The country has undergone a remarkable process of economic liberalization since 1991, transitioning towards a knowledge-based economy to become an integral part of the global marketplace. Many restrictions on foreign investment have been lifted and bureaucratic procedures simplified, creating an attractive environment for foreign businesses. New Delhi is India's capital, but its commercial heart lies in its most populous city, Mumbai, a financial and entertainment hub located on the western coast, a 14-hour flight from New York. In the south, Bangalore is the leading IT exporter, boasting thriving aerospace, telecoms and defense industries, while the states of Gujarat in the west and West Bengal in the east also attract heavy investment. But with more than 150 special economic zones welcoming businesses with export-linked tax exemptions, growth is not restricted to any one region. Today, Indian cities account for 37 of the world's 300 fastest-growing urban centers. While foreign direct investment is automatically permitted in many sectors, in others, it is capped with investment ceilings or permitted only with government approval. In some industries, foreign direct investment is prohibited outright. New entrants must take care to adhere to stringent foreign exchange controls, regulating the flow of money in and out of the country, and to comply with transfer pricing regulations, which differ in some respects from OECD guidelines. Assessing the reliability of potential staff and suppliers can be challenging, as can avoiding corruption in a country where the payment of speed money to officials is perceived as widespread. Foreign investors face a number of choices in selecting the optimal company structure. A liaison office allows companies to promote their interests but not conduct any business activity, with all expenses to be paid through inbound remittances. A branch office, which similarly requires approval from the Reserve Bank of India, allows companies only to exchange in certain specified activities. Foreign companies with a contract with a local firm can set up a project office to undertake the work. Firms seeking greater flexibility in their activities can establish a wholly owned subsidiary or a joint venture, while those seeking flexibility in their management structure can opt for a limited liability partnership. Foreign companies are taxed at 42% as opposed to the 32.4% effective tax rate for local companies. Local companies also face a tax of 16.23% on dividends paid to shareholders. For individuals, income tax in the executive pay bracket is charged at $1,665 plus 30% for income in excess of 800,000 rupees, about $14,480. VAT of 12.5 to 15% applies to most goods, with lower rates for other items, including those deemed of basic necessity. India is a dynamic market, offering rich rewards but challenging the uninitiated. Make sure you have local knowledge on your side. TMF, Vyapar ka Vaishvikaran, globalizing business.